Roger, I kind of figured you'd have a big smile on your face after that one.
Sure, I'm very happy. God, what a match. You know, I was able to play tonight. You know, it started off tough, and I thought I was in for a long night, and I was, thank God, mistaken, you know. I mean, it worked well for me. I kind of, from the start, I had a good feeling, and actually didn't have any muscle pain from my 5-setter against Burdich, so I think that was key as well. And yeah, I'm delighted about my performance tonight.
We were trying to remember a last top 10 player that took a beating like that, and we couldn't remember one, but you mentioned Burdich. Mm. What is the difference between those two players? Both good up-and-coming players. Burdich's just weighted shot from the back of the court caused you a little trouble in the first two sets. Just a heavier ball?
Well, I mean, I guess different conditions too, you know. I think during the daytime, the balls fly much more. I struggled with that early on, and especially I had a terrible start to Burdich's match. I thought I was coming kind of running behind, and Burdich, I thought, played an excellent match for three sets, actually. So I kind of, like, it took me a while to find my rhythm, and thank God I found it. And tonight, I was there right away. Balls weren't flying. I read his serve. I was feeling good, you know. I was moving well. And kind of things just clicked tonight, you know. This is one of those days.
Certainly did. Did you get a chance to watch the Djokovic-Kamrodic match?
Yeah, I saw everything. I mean, it was a fun match to watch, you know, because I thought, you know, it was kind of close for two sets, and I think it was deserved, you know, that it went one set all, I think, you know. And then kind of Andy, I think, really played solid. I was impressed how well he played, you know, and I think it's going to be a tough match for me, the next one, but definitely a bit of a surprise, you know, to see Djokovic, a defending champion, go out.
Yeah, I'm sure you'll be diplomatic, but we're kind of surprised also with the heat getting into him like that and seeing him stop.
Well, I mean, it's happened before. So, I mean, it's not the guy who's never given up in his career, you know. So that's kind of disappointing to see, you know, when you got two top guys playing each other and you give up. I mean, he gave up against me in Monaco this year because of sore throat. Yeah, so, I mean, those are kind of things, you know, you wonder about. I've only given up basically once in my career. That came just now in Paris against Blake when I couldn't move because of my back, you know. But I think Andy pushed him there. And Andy, probably would have run away anyway with him. Match, so I think Andy completely deserved the match.
Yeah, well, you're playing great tennis. It's going to be a great semi-final between you and Andy. All the best.
Hope so. Thanks a lot.